Hello and welcome to lab. Today we're going to do experiment 3, stoichiometric calculations and graphing. The experiment that we're going to do today is the basis for many breathalyzer tests. I'd like you to follow along in the lab manual and I'd like you to be my lab partner. The first step says to obtain some 0.125 molar potassium dichromate in a small beaker, then normalize a 10 milliliter pipette with that solution, and also to obtain some DI water in a very small beaker. And I'll do that right now. Now that I've normalized my pipette, I can now pipette a 10 milliliter sample into my Erlenmeyer flask. All of this potassium dichromate solution, anything that contains it, what we're doing today, must be put in a waste beaker. And at the end of the experiment, we are going to dispose of that in hazardous waste. Chromium is a very toxic compound, and that cannot go down the drain. I've got exactly 10 milliliters, and I will put that in my Erlenmeyer flask. Again, you might see a little bit of potassium dichromate solution still left in the pipette. This is calibrated to deliver, so that's okay. If you do see a little drop at the end, go ahead and touch the tip of the pipette to the side of the Erlenmeyer flask, and that will just kind of make that drop go down into solution. In step 3, I see that we've been assigned solution 3 to make. And solution 3 has 15 drops of 10% ethanol and 5 drops of DI water. So first I will add the 15 drops of the 10% ethanol. And then I will add 5 drops of DI water. And then we are going to mix this solution for 5 minutes. Now that our solution has reacted for 5 minutes, we can now in step 5, add 39 milliliters of DI water. And if you can see any of the other solution on the sides, we might just target it, but it looks like I've gotten everything. And we're just going to swirl that to mix. Now we can measure this in our spectrometer. The spectrometer has already been calibrated, and what it is going to do is give us an absorbance value. And we will end up making a graph of absorbance versus percent ethanol, and then we'll be able to determine the percent ethanol in an unknown solution. All right, let's go to the spectrometer. Now we're ready to analyze our sample in the spectrometer. This is our spectrometer. There is a light source in the front of this instrument, and the light will go through our sample onto the detector in the back of the instrument. Now the difference in the light incident to the sample and what the detector sees is the amount of light that the sample absorbed. The detector will calculate that absorbance, and we have a program that will display it on our computer. The first thing we need to do is we need to normalize our cuvette, and this is our sample holder. And of course, we're going to put this to waste, and we're going to fill up our cuvette almost all the way to get any drops of that other sample out, and that will go to waste. Now we can fill up our cuvette a little bit from the top. And we're going to wipe off the sides with a kimwipe, and we're wiping off any solution that might have gotten on the outside of our cuvette, any fingerprints or dirt, and we will put that in the spectrometer and we will read our value. Now, while we are reading this value and we can put it up on the board for the rest of the class, we can calculate the percent ethanol in 1 milliliter and the percent ethanol in the final solution. These are in your data table, while the rest of the class analyzes their samples in the spectrometer. Let's record the percent ethanol in 1 milliliter and the percent ethanol in the final prepared solution for our solution, which was number 3. 20 drops is 1 milliliter. So to calculate the percent ethanol in 1 milliliter, we'll take the number of drops of ethanol, 15, times the percent ethanol, 10, and using the dilution formula, that will equal some percent times 20 drops total, or 1 milliliter. And we can calculate that the percent ethanol in 1 milliliter is 7.5% for solution 3. So to calculate the percent ethanol in the final prepared solution, we'll take the 7.5% in 1 milliliter, and again using the dilution formula, the final volume is 50 milliliters. Therefore, the percent in solution is 0.15%. Please calculate the percent ethanol in 1 milliliter of solution and the percent ethanol in the final prepared solution for the remaining 2 solutions. This graph shows the output from the spectrometer. Absorbance is on the y-axis, and the wavelength is on the x-axis. Our value for solution 3 gives an absorbance of 0.218, and that can be found in the red oval in the bottom of the graph. The following is absorbance data for all solutions for the whole class. There are 5 points for each solution, and there is also a 0% ethanol absorbance value, which you will need to include on your graph. Please copy this data, including the color of the solution, onto your data sheet. Then construct a graph of the following 2 parameters: absorbance and percent ethanol in the final prepared solution. And you'll be able to find that as your 5th row in your data sheet. Please plot all the values for each solution. So there should be 5 values for each final prepared solution. To analyze the percent ethanol in our unknown, and here's our unknown number right here, we needed to add 10 milliliters of the 0.125 molar dichromate solution to the flask. I've already done that. And then we'll add 20 drops of our unknown. and then we'll mix for 5 minutes like we did before. Now that we're done reacting our unknown sample with the dichromate solution, we can add our 39 milliliters of DI water. And we will mix that. And now we can also analyze this in the spectrometer. We'll have to normalize our cuvette again. I'm going to fill that all the way to the top. Get rid of all the other sample that was in there. And then fill it up for analyzing. Once again, I'm going to wipe off the sides of the cuvette with a kimwipe and put it in our spectrometer. And we will read this absorbance now for our unknown. This is the output from the spectrometer for our unknown. Record the absorbance value in the red oval at the bottom of the graph in your data sheet. Well, we're done with our experiment now, and we are going to clean up. Anything that has contained the potassium dichromate solution, so definitely your unknown and your known, needs to be disposed of in waste. And then we'll transfer this waste to the hazardous waste carboy in the back hood. And then we'll put all our equipment in the middle for the next group. Let's do the first two problems in the calculation section of this lab. First in the box, let's complete that. For the percent ethanol, please record the percent ethanol in your final prepared solution. We had solution 3, and that was 0.15. This is a volume percent, where percent here has the units of milliliters of ethanol per 100 milliliters of solution, and they are the same number, so we will also enter 0.15 in that box. Now, moving on to question 1. Based on this value in the box, we're going to complete the equation to calculate the grams of ethanol in our final prepared solution. And the density of ethanol is given. So we'll use the 0.15 milliliters of ethanol per 100 milliliters of solution. We had diluted our solution and recorded the absorbance value when the volume was 50 milliliters of solution, so we'll multiply by that, and then we'll multiply by the density, leaving 0.059 grams of ethanol. We're going to use this value for calculations 2 through 7. So based on the grams of ethanol, 0.059 in the calculation we just did, we are going to calculate first the following, the grams of potassium dichromate that reacted. We'll need the balanced chemical equation, and then we will use dimensional analysis. We'll start with the grams of ethanol and convert that to moles using the molar mass. We'll then use the balanced chemical equation to convert from moles of ethanol to moles of potassium dichromate, and then we'll multiply by the molar mass of potassium dichromate, and our final result is 0.25 grams of potassium dichromate. Thank you for being my lab partner.